Ibrox Stadium packed to capacity with bedlam all around as Rangers start the match playing against the league leaders Hearts, who've brought a tremendous support through from Edinburgh. So a matchless occasion this afternoon as far as Scottish football is concerned, and with the conditions chilly overhead, the underfoot position is absolutely perfect. So Ray Wilkins, who's playing in midfield for Rangers, is joined by a very creative threesome, Ferguson, Durrant and Cooper in that area of the field. And at number two, playing at right back, is young Scott Nisbet. There he is, starting his third match at right back. He was a star of the Scottish youth team in Chile last month. The ball is still in play. There's no one with Robert Fleck. Here's a chance for Rangers. And the diving header came from anyone in the world, looking for McCoist, and that brave diving header goes just over the bar.
There's Galloway, up done by Robertson to Foster. Off the crossbar.
McCoist makes a run ahead. He's away from McPherson. Good play by McCoist. A delicate ball across. Kenny Black. And it's Robert Fleck for Rangers. An absolute gift for Robert Fleck. The 28 minutes into the first half, and Hearts, after playing so well for so long, concede a gift goal to Fleck. Cooper, first of all. Here's some excellent play from Ali McCoist. Goes inside McPherson the first time, then goes outside. This is a fine pass that Black should have cleared it, tried to pass it back to Smith, and the task couldn't have been easier in the end. Green has not been involved in the match very much for Hearts. There's a free kick though, brought down by Nisbet. Now the referee will not allow the Hearts physio on the field for treatment, ordering him off and insisting that the match continues. John Cahoon is still on the ground. Good control from Cooper. This is Wilkins. Oh, good play from Wilkins. Settled in very quickly to the Rangers setup. Phillips going forward, beaten by Barnes. This is Kenny Black. John Cahoon is still on the ground. Robertson beaten by Goff. This is Galloway. Tremendous goal from Mike Galloway. The first goal of his career at Tynecastle. And Mike Galloway will remember that, I'm sure, for a very long time. Galloway coming from midfield. There was a tackle from Goff. Now watch this from Galloway. Looks up, hits that with stunning pass, swerving into the top corner. And looks.
Kenny Black going back to battle hard for Hearts, but he's lost out to McCoist. McCoist has support on the outside from Durrant. There's Fleck. It's gone in. It's an own goal. Rangers take the lead. This is a high-class ball inside. Fleck going for it, but it came off Levein, and Smith was beaten.
McCoy's head flick. Here's Foster. Kenny Black linking Robertson. Foster!
Held on by Foster, away by Goff. Derek Ferguson calming things down, and Cooper trying to thump the ball forward. Whittaker blocks it. Here's John Robertson, very dangerous in this position. And splendidly challenged yet again. Gary Mackay.
And the shot from Galloway, beaten away by Hearts midfield player. Just look at this for the first time volley. And very sharp goalkeeping by Woods.
Well, corner kick. There's McPherson.
Turned in by Robertson. The ball's in the net. And Hearts are back on level terms. The never say die spirit of Hearts pays off again. McPherson doing well. Get his head to the ball. There was Robertson right in front of Chris Woods. The despairing effort on the line by Ferguson. But it was too late. And Hearts are back on level terms.
Robertson did well. There goes Galloway, beaten by Nisbet. That appeared to be handball by Ferguson.
It looked a very close thing, that, for Derek Ferguson.
This is Fleck. Now Durrant. Shooting chance for Durrant. Yes!
17 minutes.
3-2 down with about 12 minutes left for play. Gillis one from Galloway, Wilkins has possession, and here's Durrant breaking again on the left. Fleck and McCoy stood up in the middle. Durrant retaining possession all the way himself. A fine save by Henry Smith, and suddenly Ian Durrant has come to life. Congratulated there by Wilkins. But Durrant looks a new man now since he switched position after Francis came on for Davy Cooper. A fine save. Goff is up with the attack, beaten by McPherson. Nisbet plays it wide for Francis, so deadly with these crosses from the right. Smith couldn't make it, he got a touch though. He eased the ball away, only as far as Durrant. Wilkins spraying the play again. Francis inside to Nisbet. A good opening again for Rangers. Nisbet going in the near post. Going all the way himself. Fleck trying to find a shooting chance and it's scrambled. Kidd is forced to play it back to Henry Smith. The referee checking his watch. Only seconds remaining and no more time left. Rangers are the winners by 3-2. A truly magnificent Premier League match. Rangers winning in the end thanks to a superb finish from Ian Durrant. It was a substitution of Francis, but Cooper had been all the difference because it released Durrant to the left side of the Rangers midfield. It was from that position he went through the middle to score the goal which won the match for Rangers, and the victory just about merited over the piece for Rangers. What a courageous battle